And as you get to a tabletop position, please feel free to move around a little bit. Like, if stillness is the answer, you can be still. But I reckon if I were you, I'd be moving around a little bit. Yeah, moving the hips side to side. Gabby 1, I like it. That's good stuff. It'll be Gabby 1 and Gabby 2. I don't know which one's which, but, you know, we'll play that way. Cow calves are cool. Shifting side to side, pressing back to a child's pose, whether you've been there or have not been there, is all right. I do want to see fingers spread wide to where our body meets the mat. We want to make substantial connections. And if there's any way you can connect your breathing to your movement, I'd encourage you to do so. Whether that means you're taking your cow cats, one breath per movement, maybe that means shifting the hips, shifting the body with that ujjayi, that would be a pretty good idea, I think. I'm starting to hear a fair ujjayi breath. There are a lot of bodies in this space, so I do have a pretty high expectation for what I'm looking for in terms of ujjayi. Let's continue to build on that. Those of you that are more in depth, kind of take the reins here. We are conductors. Those of you that are just dialing in, keep the ears open and join us as it's possible. Find downward facing dog whenever you're ready. Down dog is a shape that we're going to return to and visit many times. It doesn't always have to be the shape for you, so please do feel free to substitute something else in. I'd maybe suggest a tabletop position or even dropping down to a child's pose would be a fine way to give your body some rest. There ain't no denying that down dog is some work. We're trying to find length in this shape. We're not really in a high push-up position. What we're actually in is a long shape. Trying to find as much length as we can. Eric, I love it. From our wrists up past our tailbone. I know that this practice, JC, I love what I'm feeling. I know that this practice is a generally tough, you know, not tough, but it's an empowered practice, but softness is encouraged too. So like bending the knees a little bit, easing the body to maybe find some more space is not a bad idea. You can always log your hands back towards your toes. Like, length doesn't mean necessarily front to back length. It means like body length. If that makes any sense to y'all. Reagan, that looks lovely. Gabby, too, that looks pretty good. And whenever you're ready, set your right leg long behind you. We're taking the leg straight out. So we're not taking it to the moon. Well done. Toes are flexed forward, heels pressing back. Of course, fingers are still spread wide. Maybe we drop this just a little bit. Maybe a little bit more. Maybe right there. Maybe we lift this a little bit, Scott. Thank you. Jesse, you could probably lift a little bit too. Thank you, brother. Whenever you're ready, inhale, press that foot back. As you exhale, knee to nose or third eye, which is the center of your forehead. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, right knee to the left elbow, we'll go across body, and do try to make contact, even if it's the top. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, right to right. So right knee, right elbow. You might bump it up the arm of the tricep if you got space. Nice gate. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, knee to nose or third eye, pause. Let's hold there. Try to make contact. Roll up, Laura. Roll up, Bailey. Try not to kick the foot back. Put the foot between your hand. Left hand low, right hand high overhead. This place. And you can float the top arm forward. You can take a little bind ski, wrap that hand around the back. You can drop your knee. You drop the knee, grab the wood, a little leg. Still breathing. We're definitely staying high on the ball of our back foot. We're definitely making sure that our right knee is straight ahead. and our heels are on, well, the front heel's on the ground, back heel is lifted, and the more you get up on the ball of that back foot, the more you can sink down into that front knee. Good shakes, friends, good shakes. Look up, reach up, lift the left knee, if it ain't up, take a deep inhale. As you exhale, plant your hand, right foot lifts, heel open, three layer of lift off. Leg dog, we're stacking our hips. Flip dog, we're going up and over. Great belly back bend. What I did not love was the sound that I heard. I heard a fair amount of feet drag as they step back. I will not stand for that. That's just not how we operate here. We do mind with it. We take each movement with precision and strength. We can't do such. Then we modify and adapt our practice to allow ourselves to move consciously. Breathing is building nicely. Let's take a deep breath in. As you exhale, we'll all be back in downward facing dog. We're in a position to suit your needs a little bit better. Imagine you're ready, extend the left leg long behind you. Again, the legs are not super high in the air. Our hips are level, as a matter of fact. Inhale, press the foot back. Exhale, meet your nose, your third eye. Actually, not too shabby. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, we're going to go cross-body. And this one's tough. Try to make contact. Inhale, lengthen. Rachel, I like that. Exhale, left to left, and again, keep it way up on that left arm. Maybe get yourself ready for an arm balance. Inhale, lengthen. As you exhale, knee comes forward, pause. I do encourage you to try to touch your nose, or the center of your forehead. Maybe get high on the ball of that foot. Maybe drop the ground away from you a little bit more. As long as your fingers are spread wide, take one more deep breath in. As you exhale, place the foot between your hand. Job just did. Let's twist the other way. Wait. Low left eye. Options, of course, to make this thing feel good to you, however that is.
Swears, that's cool. Sometimes being still
is the way to go. Don't artificially introduce movement into your practice, but if you are moving, come to stillness, release your hands if they're anchored, and toe-heel your feet back together to touch. From here, inhale, lift to a flat back, core is engaged, gaze is down, shoulders drop back, no rounding at all, no bullshit is accepted. Exhale, fold forward, I draw the ear, stick right into that up. One more time, inhale, flat back, again, straighten it out. Exhale, release, Rachel, straighten that out a little bit more. Next time you breathe in, inhale, sweep up, reach up, look up, take it back, bend, move side to side, lift the toes, get fucking working out. Exhale, release. And I'm trying to start to pace things out when we're introducing that pause at the top of the inhale, the bottom of the exhale. Next time you breathe in, long spine, like fully lengthening out. Exhale, release. Again, inhale, sweep, reach, rise. Do the yoga day. And as you exhale, forward, forward. Let it be sweet. Like, I feel like the slower you move, the more you can explore. Half lift, that's that flat back. First vinyasa of the practice, and I know I got a few new heads, but I'm going to give you all the benefit of the doubt. Take your first vinyasa. That's high to low push-up as you breathe out. Inhale, up dog. Then it'll be an exhale with down dog. Once again, moving with your breath pace, finding that pause at the maximum and minimum points of those movements. Inhale, lift the toes. Exhale, make your way forward. Nice step, Jesse. That was perfect, actually. Yeah, that looks good. Long spine. Actually, straighten out a little bit more. Draw the shoulders back, engage the core. There you go. Fold forward. Sweep, reach, rise. Again, get funky if you want to. Sometimes not getting funky is the best answer. Release. There you go, Laura, long spine. You don't have to wait for me to cue it out if your breath dictates otherwise. Vinyasa. Hearing less feet move around the mat, so that's good news to my ears. Take one more sade on your end. See what some moves we just took, go for it. Not bad steps, Sarah. You see this may happen. The gaze is a little up, I'd rather be more down, but you've got the flat back. Which is the harder thing to down. So whenever you get back to downward facing dog, pause. And again, if down dog is not your thing, you can find an alternative rest position. But we're going to take one round of sun salutation B. We're not going to build it. We're just going to take one time through. So whenever you're ready, inhale into the toes. Exhale, make your way forward. Half lift. Oh, Uttanasana. Release. Half lift. position up to a low push-up position, or a high push-up. It's a little bit different. So I can beat your body up as much. As you get back, the next time you breathe in, right foot forward, warrior one. It's not bad, Bailey. Sure, you do have to move the fucking pad. It's in front. Thank you. And the next time, warrior two. And then you inhale and reverse your warrior. And you exhale, and find your vinyasa, Kirsten Apples, and glutes, and shoulder, high levels, leg close. Elbows in, Misera, elbows in, rotate your high low. As you get back to down low, the next inhale is left foot forwards for warrior one, square hips, Eric. Nice job, Rachel. And then as you exhale, warrior two. Get back heel on the ground in warrior one spot. And as you inhale, reverse. And as you exhale, vinyasa. As you get back down, face the dog. I regularly play it this way. Inversion of your choosing. You can also do an arm balance. Your vibe, so whatever you're feeling, let's get some energy out. It can be a headstand, handstand, forearm balance, tripod headstand. You can do a forearm plank. You can do a crow pose. You can do a side crow pose. You can do ekapada, whatever you want to do. Or you can rest. You can lay there and just freaking chill. That's up to you, my friend. Do what you gotta do, Eric. That ain't bad. That ain't bad at all. If you're going up and you're not getting all the way up, try to keep your landings light. Obviously, there's going to be a thud every now and then, but let's try to control that. Jesse, always excellent exodus of the poses. Bailey, that's good. I don't think you really beat that wall. I see that you got the strength, though, so dial that shit in, my friend. Come on. Yeah, that was pretty good. That was a pretty good way to like maintain that. And this is it, maybe, but trying to keep these forearms parallel. I'm gonna do this. I do that a lot too. I have to say it, you know. Laura, super stacked. You're almost like, I'm gonna do those things out of the floor. There you go. Nice, Jesse. Yo! At some point, we will all find rest. We will all find rest. And rest can be, again, open to interpretation. Don't have to do child's pose. It doesn't have to be laying there. It can be sitting there, kneeling there. You can stand there even. I wouldn't change a stick of that. It'd be an unusual movement in and out. I would hate it. I'd say one of the reasons why I like to go that early intensity action at you is like, how do you respond? Are you able to let the breath come back to that steady jet ease out when you're chilling? Is your mind all over the place? Are you unable to be still? That's the challenge. I don't give a shit if you take the conversion, but it doesn't matter. I want to see how you can transition between the different circumstances. Now we're facing dog whenever you're ready to move and groove again. So let's build a little bit upon stuff we already touched on. Extend the right leg long behind you and pause. And again, we're not taking it to the moon here. I want to level hip to heel. So if you your heels higher than your hip, drop it down. If your heels lower than your hip, you're gonna lift it up. Inhale, thrust the foot back. You see you draw out the big toes. As you exhale, knee to nose and third eye. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, light knee to left elbow. We're going to hold it there this time. For five, there is an arm balance if you know it. Four, Ashley, that's bad ass. Three, two, nice job, Eric. One, nice job, Jesse. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, light to right. This is a little bit more accessible in terms of arm balance and maintaining. I love this. That's good work by you. Nice job, Bailey. For five. For four. For three. Not back here. Stand two. One. Inhale, lengthen. This is my favorite one. Exhale, knees, nose, your third eye. We're going to hold it there. Fingers bent wide. Sarah. For five. We're not going to keep our leg back at all. Four. We're going to get high on the lower back. Go for three. Nice job, Laura. Two. And again, the leg does not kick back. Why don't we just place it in your hands? Sweep up. Press the line. Yeah. That was pretty good. In here. This is a long shape. We want to find as much space as we can front to back. We got a long mat. They're longer than our bodies. Take up some real estate. The best use I was ever given was if you think you're high with all of your back foot, it again. You're higher up on that thing. And then wiggle the leg before it's in further down. All of a sudden, really start to take up some real estate. Got this. Inhale. So this is a shift and lift, right? Like a shift and lift. Think of it that way. And if you're looking back here, Gabby, well, you know it. Just use your stay focused, all right? Just make a deep breath in, and as you exhale, shift your weight to your right foot and lift into a warrior three. We're keeping our hips level and our head to hip to heel level as we find this warrior three. Sure, you want to say, extend those arms. Do you have the most tennis elbows? Finger spread wide. Nice job, Justin. Laura, that's exemplary. Jesse, that's pretty good. I can see maybe an upper body drop, lower body lift. There you go. Make sure you drop the left hip a little bit down. Drop a little bit down. Way to work it, my friend. So I keep that leg strong. I know that you do have ring behind you, so don't kick your head, but you know, think about it. If you're not there yet, bring your hands to heart center. Take a deep breath in. I did say I was going to cook y'all. Bouncing half of it, right hand, left hand, high overhead. Yeah, we're staying on one foot. Good humor, Ashley. At least you can laugh about it. If you can laugh about it, you can do it. This is a great spot to use a block. Bring the ground close to our bodies is never a bad idea. Especially if your leg's quaking and shaking. I have to sit over all there, actually. That's a pretty solid looking pose. Good feel of it. Very nice. Once again, Scott, your leg's a little like, you know, you can just like straighten it out and maybe lift it a little bit more. And maybe if like, you know, open up a little bit more, and then I'm going to step away, which I feel like you don't go down, got this, you get this, make sure that your right toes face forward, I'm not going to leave you, like right or left toes face forward, there you go, I'm not going to leave you, I'm going to dial you in, come on, now I'm going to leave you, lock it, come on, Scott, hey, that wasn't bad, it lasted, better on this one, right? Rachel. Not bad people, not bad people. Take one more deep breath in. Sarah, lift that back leg. Let's get some water. Palms here. You can make a side crow, but don't do it to get out of the work that's being done. Strong bodies, Caitlin, that's excellent. Some decent side crows, very strong Laura. Rachel, I bet you got it. Come on, there it is. Let's take one more deep breath in. As you exhale, fold forward. Half lift. Feet together. Right hand low, left hand high, side plank. Little side plank at jump. You can drop the bottom knee, you can flip the top leg. There's always something that goes the wrong way. That's okay. Everybody's got to be an individual. You can take a little toe grab. You can take a tree pose. You can drop a knee, grab a foot. There you go, Scott. Keep under control. Keep breathing. But you can grab a toe, Ashley. I bet you can grab a toe. If you try to grab a toe, you can grab a toe. Oh, wow. Wow, look how good that almost looks. Let's take a deep breath in. As you exhale, lower down on the outside.
All right, whenever you're ready,
go ahead and lift your left leg while behind you and pause. Inhale, press back. Exhale, lean the nose or third eye. It's just getting us moving. And then inhale, lengthen. Exhale, cross body. This is like the second hardest one for five. Four. Three, Jesse. That was interesting. Two. One. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, left to left for five. Three more balance. Four. Three. I have to say both gaps. I mean, come on, what do you got? I know you can get that knee to your elbow. Two. Wow, look what just happened. One. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, knee to nose or third eye, and we're going to hold it here for five. And we're not going to take our leg back, correct? Four. We're definitely going to use our arms and back leg. Three. And most certainly our core. Two. We're going to try to keep our palms flat. One. Nice job, Eric. A place to put between your hands. That's impressive. Drop the workout, guy. Now, you know, I'm not going to subscribe. Drop that in.
and bring your hands to our center, take a deep breath in as you exhale, fucking got bouncing out.
Ray, that's an excellent looking pose. Rachel, that's a wonderful looking pose. Scott, I'm telling you, you will balance your body out if you just extend it out, lift it leg. If you would just commit to straighten that out, you got long legs. Imagine that stability, that counterbalance you're going to get from that there. It'll be a wonderful thing. Eric, that's not bad. That leg is going a little rogue towards the wall. Bring it back towards your neighbor. Thank you. Now look it up. Thank you. Take a deep breath in. Look up. Reach up. Maybe close your bottom hand. Might not get a little saucy. As you exhale, step back. Warrior two. Bring it in. Step back. Look at him. Checking here still. You see that's not bad. That is better now, that will see. Go ahead. Straighten that front leg. Inhale, reach. Exhale, entire body. You are talking, Rachel. That's beautiful. Talking the left side on. Same three options. I would encourage you folks to do the option you didn't do or one of the options you didn't do last time. Land if you're inverted, rise if you're down low. And then we'll all walk our hands out to that nice flat back. Hands to hands, keep that back nice and flat. Deep breath in, straighten out even more. Let's drop Sarah. As you actually roll up to standing, JC, I love that exercise right there. That was fantastic. Left nose. Face forward, right foot steps up to jaw. Inhale, sweep your hands up. Kupitasana, three out. Sink low. In the chair right now. That is awesome. But as Nikki said, we in a chair right now. So stick your hands on your chest. Or
way there are some straight arms in this room.
Side crow if you want to. I will say that this is some better looking side chairs than I'm used to seeing. I could see it sweetened up a little bit, but overall it's not bad. I do see some long spines. Actually, you can probably see your hips with your chest a little bit higher. You got the strap the other way down there. So, this has got a little distance to go. Like, imagine this. Like, we're gonna work a little bit longer for a second. So, imagine that, like, you were, like, down here. You're here, right? Now, you bring this up a little bit, though. So, you work here then, right?
Yeah.
This is where you work. And then you can go lower, twist more. So, you don't have to get that. Keep this.
Okay.
All right, let's take a deep breath in. As you exhale, fold forward. Well done. Half lifts. High plank. Feet together. Left hand low, right hand high overhead. We get that side plank down. And that side plank again. Nice job, Kristen. Really, I love it. Ricky, I love that option, quite honestly. I love to see something a little bit different. Flat palms. Think you have one. Forearm straight ahead. Thank you. Chuck Pearson, Chuck JC. Let's take one more deep breath in. As you exhale, square up. Vinyasa. That's one exhale to low push-up. Inhale up dog. Exhale downward facing dog. Inhale into nose. Exhale somehow, some way, maybe standing at the top of the your hand, just like try to find a tree. And you're foot might not be as high as you're used to, that's okay. If your foot's anywhere on your knee, we do want to adjust that. So try to use your hand. Yeah. Not bad, Sarah.
I don't know if your
hands are on, but it's a good setup. All right, so we got a little bit funky at this point, right? We got a little bit of dojo on, so. And here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna try to find wheel pose from here. And I've only seen two people ever find wheel pose from this, so I'm not expecting you pose to do it. Actually, it has happened. It's happened in this space. You might be the third person. What you're gonna do is you're gonna press the shit out of your foot in your leg. That's the foundation. You're gonna engage your core, and you're gonna start pushing it forward and kneel back. And there's gonna be that other shit point. So like, I mean, I will demonstrate. I've never done it. Jesse's doing a great job of demonstrating. So you're just gonna like go back, and you're gonna go back, and you keep going back, and you're gonna keep going back, going back, going back, going back, and then maybe you go back so far you can fight hands on the ground. Or you bail like I just did. The point here is that we put ourselves in an uncomfortable position, and then maybe we surprise ourselves with consistent commitment to the practice. You might be the third person coming up, actually. I don't know. You're closer than you think. So again, it's just like having good humor. It's like, you know, becoming comfortable with doing shit you cannot do. Alright, I see some people taking a couple extra turns for a while. Alright. Let's shake it out. We're gonna have to do it on the other side. Shake it out, make yourself feel good. Let's do a little rinse. I think we should rinse this. Inhale, keep your hands high. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, lift halfway. Exhale, release. And make your way up to standing. Once again, I do encourage you to move slow. You're like, this is a sweet moment, like, peace by peace, roll up. And whenever you're ready, sweep your hands high, lift the left leg, and remember this is the lowest your leg's gonna go. Smart move, Miss Kirsten. Inhale, lift the leg a little bit higher. We're gonna lift it up again. And one more time, you're gonna lift it up, Rachel. That's the application I like to see. And then as you exhale, send it back from that airplane pose, that Urban Diner Asana. And happen. Keep it good. Yeah. You got it. Nicely done. Way to focus. And your level, too. Remarkably. Okay, now we're losing it. Turbulence. That was pretty good, though. Pumps. Flat to the ground, spread wide, chest lifting, checking, just adjusted. Gabriel, I can see, make that chest lifting a little bit more. Thank you. Keep the leg off the ground, breathe in. Nice job, Scott. As you breathe out, bring the leg back to center, keep the toes off the ground. We're back to where we were. Hopefully your leg's as high as it was. Tree pose, Vrikshasana. So we ended up doing the old four effecta of one leg of balancing poses. We know it's upon us. We know that we're going to approach it with humor. And curiosity. Keep the hands high. Set it up. Make it happen. I like it. I love it. I love it. I love it. Continue to do it. Combine it. Exhale, fold forwards.
And flat palms, Sarah. A little bit takes to get on there. Yeah, there we go.
Inhale, lift halfway. Downward facing dog. Vinyasa. Downward facing dog. Go ahead and look at the space between your hands. Inhale at the toes. And as you exhale, just hop, float, or crawl a little off like it's in position. And let's take a little pause here. If you're ready, inhale, sweep your hands high overhead. Keep your gaze lifted as you exhale, fold forward for a long legged seated fold here. I would recommend you flex your toes back towards your knees. I would recommend that you don't grab your ankles, that you kind of engage your core and lift your chest, and as you exhale, fold a little deeper here. Take a deep breath in. As you exhale, slowly roll up, like slow. And then you're going to slowly roll onto your backs. Maybe grab on a block. I'm going to find a bridge, more support bridge here. Don't just like flop yourself down here, like, you know, come on your elbows, forearms, use your core, or if you got to do. Bridge support bridge is where we're going to start. Knees are bent, all 10 toes face forward, feet are hips width distance apart. I wouldn't go too narrow, I wouldn't go too wide. You do want to find that Goldilocks zone. I am a big fan of support bridge, it's one of my favorites. You have to use two blocks here if you really want to find something a little different. If you're interested in that, I can show you how that's done. But whenever you're ready, inhale, lift off, come out. Round one of three. It's going to be a pretty light night in terms of that bending. Okay, so I love it. Disciple of the two blocks. I mean, if you're not using a block, though, like your palms are pressing into the ground, your forearms are pressing into the ground, your feet are pressing into the ground, you're breathing deeply, you're breathing strong, you lift Rachel. You can lift the toes, you can lift the legs off the ground. You get funky with it, you get a little bit loud, it's okay. Everybody take one more deep breath in. As you exhale, lower down a little bit. Like, actually, I saw that as you're lift with that last deep breath in. Utilize the breath of fire, that raising of the body. So we have two more belly back bends to take here. Bridge support, bridge or wheel. Whenever you're ready, lift off the ground. And you can lift the toes. You can lift the leg off the ground. You can lift the arm off the ground if you're going to wheel pose. JC, that's nice. But Jesse, that's how you use two blocks, my guy. That's excellent. Great lift. Probably lift a little bit more if you energize those hands a little bit more. Knees forward, really. I think you do. I was going to say it. Not bad, Eric. Toes and knees forward, the superior out. Stay forward deep.
Breath in. Exhale, knees down.
It's gonna feel good. fish will support a fish, keep it. Slide your hands underneath your backside. You can utilize a block and find a supportive fish. So classic fish, your legs are together, and slide your hands underneath your butt, lower down on your forearms. I'm a big fan of supported fish when you put a block on its thin edge coming out from your lower back. Legs are together, feet are together, toes point forward. If you're supported, just kind of let that shit open up. If you're unsupported and you want a little bit more, you could float your legs. That option is up to you. If you are using a block, I wouldn't float my legs if you've committed to the chill. Take a deep breath in as you exhale, tongue out by a breath. We are aware of how that breath was described, correct? You say lion's breath, lion's letting up, I don't know, cow's cat breath. Let's take a deep breath in and as you exhale, tongue out, don't be shy, I'm gonna do it with you. Go ahead and tuck it to your chest, lower down. I got nothing to say about that. I'm sorry. I can't even. As you get back down to the ground, so you will lower to the ground, you got the option to take your final immersion of this practice. And some of you did find that upside down time. You did not. After right now, but maybe hits on a block, makes up a wall, shoulder stand, and of course the spicy options are always on the menu. That's your choice. And of course, shoulder stand can evolve to a plow, to a carne, padasana. Painful ear pose. If your feet or knees on the ground beyond your head, you're welcome to release your hands from your lower back. If you do not make contact, please continue to protect yourself.
I'll catch you folks on the other side.